Hey, this is Lisa, and today I'll explain to you how to color certain columns or cells in Datawrapper tables by category. You might also know this concept as conditional formatting, for example, from Excel or from Google Spreadsheet. So here's an example. This table shows the highest points in each country and the maximal elevation in meters. You can go through these pages here, you can search for countries, and you see Asian countries in this table are colored with an orange background and European countries are colored with a blue background. Here's how I created this table. I started with four columns. So you want to make sure to always upload the column with the categories you want to color by. In this case, these are the continents, the regions. So we have them here. And let's start simple. Let's try to color the regions in the regions column by the regions in this column. So we click on this column, region, then scroll down until we see color cells based on categories. That's what we want to click. And we do so. And now we can choose a column we want to color by. And this could be any text column. In fact, any text column you upload will appear here. We want to color by region, so we choose region. And then we can either customize the text or fill the background based on these regions. So for example, if we choose Asia, then any region with the word Asia in here will be colored the same. Let's try that out. Let's choose like an orange here, maybe like so, a little bit more orange. And okay, that works. Yes. And we see in the whole table, all these categories like Asia are now colored in the same orange. You can do the same with Europe, like so. Okay, good. That was simple. Let's try that a little bit more advanced. So we can do the same with countries. We can actually color the countries based on the continents they're on, based on this fourth column we uploaded. To do so, we choose color cells based on categories again. And instead of country, which would be the same column, we again choose region. And here we do the same. We can, for example, choose an orange for Asian countries and in blue for European countries. Okay, so here's a nifty little trick. I can actually hide the region now, like hide the region column entirely. To do so, I deselect show on desktop and I also deselect show on mobile. So none of your readers, no matter the device they're on, will see the region column now. And yeah, it still works. So we have colored the cells in the country column based on a column that's not available anymore, that doesn't show up in our table. Genius. Okay. All right, that looks good. But in our actual table that I showed you in the beginning, we saw that the whole row was in orange and that the whole, like the European countries, the whole row was in blue. So how can we achieve that? You could go through these individual columns, always click color cells based on categories, do the same for this, etc., to color them all by the region column. But that's a little bit annoying to have so much work. So instead, we can hold shift and select all the columns we want to color. So here's a problem. If you see this toggle here, like half blue, half on, half not, then this is a bad sign. Instead, make sure to have that toggled off and to have all of them toggled off before using that feature. And now if you toggle it on color cells based on category and reset all, then start again, then you see you can actually color the whole row. And we will do this for Asia and for Europe. Okay, that looks good. Maybe make Asia a little bit more orange. Okay. So if you use columns like this one in your table, make sure to explain to readers what they actually mean. So in the original table, I did something like this. I used the description field to add a color key, so to say, with some HTML styling. I will link to an Academy article below that explains how to do this. For now, I will just copy that description here and put it in my annotate tab. Okay, nice, that works well. By the way, you cannot just color by the region column, like by any column you uploaded and hide, but you can also search by it, which is fun. Because now you can, for example, search for Europe, even sort the maximal elevation in Europe, and then see a nice ranked list of all the highest mountains in Europe. You can do the same with Asia, for example, North America, etc. And that's it. If you have any more questions, leave them in the comments.